hundreds of bikers revved their engines, drove on sidewalks, and sped through red lights last night. It's become an ongoing issue throughout Chicago, and residents say they have had enough. But are protests taking away resources to curb the problem? Our Chris Hush explains.
Hundreds, possibly 1,000 motorcyclists.
They're crowding around cars. They are popping wheelies.
Riding through the South Loop.
I was on the rooftop last night till about 10. It was just like going on nonstop.
Streeterville, River North, and everywhere in between.
And it doesn't sound like it stops ever.
April Otto says the parade of bikers seems to be growing, not only in size, but frequency, coming through at any time during the weekend. This video shows bikers riding on sidewalks and plowing through intersections when stoplights are on red.
The sheer volume outnumbering the police officers means they're probably not going to get caught.
Second Ward Alderman Brian Hopkins says nearly 100 bikers were cited by Chicago police. Three arrests were made. But with protests and skyrocketing murder rates, resources are stretched thin.
If you try to chase them, two things happen. Number one, that motorcycle becomes an 800-pound missile.
Are they Chicagoans? Are they from out of state?
A lot of them are just, you know, hobbyists that may even be law-abiding in every other aspect of their life. But here's a chance for them to get together and engage in civil disobedience.
Alderman Hopkins adds sound tracking devices are set up along Lakeshore Drive, where many of these bikers travel, helping in the charging process, but only if they're caught. He plans on introducing an ordinance this year to make it easier to impound the bikes of violators and reallocate resources. He urges residents to call police to report sights and sounds like this. Chris Hush, NBC 5 News.